Hi friends, welcome to the usability testing tutorial. If you have missed the previous tutorial for DevOps testing tools, please click on link in the description box or just click on the playlist above. And friends, subscribe this channel and keep watching. So what is the big deal about this usability testing? Let's take a look on what, why, how, some tools and some examples of usability testing in this tutorial. So let's get started now. So first of all, what is usability testing? Usability testing is to determine whether an application or a website has following attributes: user-friendliness, easy navigation, easy to use, consistent designs, and accessible. Usability testing is focused on the application's user-friendly nature, and hence it is tested from the end user's point of view. An application should be easy to use and navigate for the end user who is intended to use it, while satisfying the given functional and business requirements provided by the client. Content, color, icons and images used should be aesthetically pleasing and consistent. And lastly, help should be available for the users to understand the application. Usability testing is a user-centered design technique where you evaluate a product, OT application or a website by testing it on a group of people with no prior exposure to it. This testing is also called as testing for user-friendliness. This testing is done if user interface of the application stands an important consideration and needs to be specific for the specific type of user. The goal is to measure the intuitiveness of your design, user flows, and content with users who closely represent your target market. According to Acquire Commission Global Survey done recently, there is a huge gap between consumers' expectations and the delivered product by the organizations. This gap highlights a common problem that the product team doesn't have a realistic impression of the user experience of their product. So usability testing is a great way to fulfill this gap with these outcomes. First, detect bugs and defects. Usability testing is immensely helpful in detecting defects and bugs that were not visible to the developers. Second, improve retention rate. Retaining customers is an important source of income for the organization in the retail world. By conducting usability testing, organizations can improve retention rate, as it allows them to understand why users are leaving their site and take necessary preventive measures. Third is reduced costs. It is comparatively cheaper to conduct usability testing, rather than creating a new website or redesigning a one that does not meet the requirements of the user and offers them an inferior user experience. Fourth, understand user behavior. From determining the most engaging elements on the website to identifying the pattern of user behavior, usability testing helps the team immensely and offers them data which can be used to create a better website. In addition to these four outcomes, by conducting usability testing, the team can minimize the number of support calls or inquiries users will have to make to the help desk, as they'll come across fewer usability problems and queries. There is a wide array of tools and tactics we can employ in user testing. Most user tests out there can be broken down into these 3:1. Moderated or unmoderated. 2. Remote or in-person. 3. Explorative or comparative research. Firstly, moderated or unmoderated testing methods. Moderated test is done under specific conditions and is carried out with the active help of a moderator. This moderator tends to be a UX researcher who takes notes and establishes the pace of the entire test. This type of user testing is widely popular because it can deliver some truly powerful insights into the minds of users and how they perceive your product. Unmoderated or remote testing is where there is no moderator present but online tools are used to facilitate the sessions. These are particularly beneficial if you have dispersed users or want greater flexibility. And so, if you're in Paris but your users are somewhere in Australia, doing a remote unmoderated test might be your best option. Moderated and unmoderated user testing share a lot of traits, but their main difference is the presence of moderator has huge implications. Second type is remote or in-person. Remote usability tests are done over the internet or by phone. In-person testing, as the name suggests, requires the test to be completed in the physical presence of a UX researcher or moderator. Compared to remote tests, in-person tests provide extra data points, since researchers can observe and analyze body language and facial expressions. However, in-person testing is usually expensive and time-consuming. Thirdly, explorative and comparative testing. Explorative tests are open-ended. Participants are asked to brainstorm, give opinions, and express emotional impressions about ideas and concepts. whereas comparative research methods involve asking users to choose which of two solutions they prefer, and they are used to compare a website with its primary competitors. Let's now look into some of the usability testing methods in detail. Lab usability testing. This type of usability research takes place inside a specially built usability testing lab. Test subjects complete tasks on computers, mobile devices, while a trained moderator observes and asks questions. A major benefit of lab usability testing is the control it provides. All sessions are run under the same standardized conditions, which makes it especially useful for comparison tests. Guerrilla testing. It's the simplest form of usability testing. Basically, guerrilla testing means going into a public place such as a coffee shop to ask people about your prototype. Test participants are chosen randomly. They are asked to perform a quick usability test, often in exchange for a small gift. Guerrilla testing is used to test a wide cross-section of people who may have no history with the product. It's a quick way to collect large amounts of qualitative data. Phone interviews. In a phone usability test, a moderator verbally instructs participants to complete tasks on their computer and collects feedback while the user's electronic behavior is recorded remotely. Phone interviews are an economical way to test users in a wide geographical area. Because they are less expensive than in-person interviews, they help collect more data in a shorter period. Card sorting is a testing process where participants can demonstrate how they expect your website to look in terms of its layout and navigation. A business could go for an open card sort where they start by creating cards with concepts. Users are then free to organize these cards in groups of their choosing. For instance, a participant might feel that cards with words like content and infographics should be within the website blogs section and so might put it within that group. Some businesses could also opt for a closed card sort where users can sort a card into groups that already exist. Session recording is a method of recording the actions that real users take while they interact with the site. Session recording data helps to understand what content or features are the most interesting for the users via heat map analysis, as well as what interaction problems users face while they interact with your product. Observation. In this sort of test, the researchers watch but don't participate. They may interject if a participant gets stuck, but otherwise, they remain quiet and concentrate on taking notes. Observation testing allows researchers to see the body language and facial expressions of participants without interference from a moderator. 5-second test. In this test, website owners upload a screenshot of their web page with a single question. Test subjects have 5 seconds to look at the page before they answer the question. This is an easy way to collect a large amount of qualitative data about people's first impressions and reactions to your site. Eye tracking. Researchers observe and study users' eye movements using a special pupil tracking device mounted on a computer. By analyzing where users direct their attention when asked to complete a task, the machine can create heat maps or movement pathway diagrams. This type of research method should be used by brands who are trying to determine how participants can interact with the website's design. The process of usability testing is a simple one and can be executed either by the developers, testers, or appointed users. It follows a set of 6 steps, which are: create a prototype. A prototype is an early model of a product, usually with limited functionality, built to test a design concept, a thing to be replicated or learned from. There are multiple ways to create prototypes, and there are many tools, including offline software and online apps. Test planning. The test begins with the team identifying the goals and defining the scope of testing. Furthermore, they agree upon the metrics, determine the cost of usability study, and create the test plan and test strategy. Recruiting target people. Once the necessary plan is prepared, the team and the resources are assembled and the tasks are assigned accordingly. Finally, the team lead or manager decides the reporting tools and templates, which will be used for test execution. Test execution. It is in this stage of the process that the team performs the usability test, during which they communicate the scope of testing and capture unbiased results. Analysis and documenting the test result. After test execution, the team categorizes the results and identifies the patterns among them, which are then used to generate inferences. Reporting. Finally, once the analysis of the results is completed, the team offers actionable recommendations as well as stakeholder briefing to help rectify issues and to remove any issues regarding the testing. The usability testing checklist is divided into 3 parts: accessibility, navigation, and content. Section 1 is accessibility. Check if font size and spacing between the texts is properly readable. Check the load time of the website is realistic. Check if appropriate alt tags are added for images. A sitemap is very important for a large site because it helps lost users find their way and also makes it easy for search engines to spider your site. Take a look at your error messages and consider whether they just tell the user they're wrong or if they actually provide suggestions for how to remedy the problem. Section 2, Content. Check if styles and colors are consistent. Check if major headings are clear and descriptive. Check if URLs are meaningful and user-friendly. Check if HTML page titles are explanatory. Check if critical content is above the fold and content is concise and explanatory. Also check if you have offered contact information. Section 3, Navigation. Use color, position, size, and more to create a specific flow for your site. Check if a user effortlessly recognizes the website navigation. Check if navigation options are understandable and short. Check if site search is present on page and should be easy to access. Check if a style of links is consistent on all pages and easy to understand. Ensure that your visitor always knows where links are headed by discussing the site before you ask them to click here. Usability testing tools are growing in numbers and features. But which is the right one for you? Take a look at this list of these 10 awesome platforms and find out. Here is a list of some of the usability testing tools which are either free or give a free trial. We would discuss these tools in our upcoming video. If you run an e-commerce store, you need to focus on essential tasks like product discovery and checkout. Focus on these 5 areas to reduce abandoned carts and create more loyal customers. First is navigation or discovery. Think if the users are able to quickly find the products they are looking for without issue. Secondly, editing cart. Can customers see all products in their cart and edit the volume of each product, as well as remove items from current orders easily? Third is ordering products. Does the website make it easy for first-time and returning customers to order? Fourth, checkout. Can users quickly complete checkout without running into any unexpected actions or other roadblocks? And the fifth is contacting support for help. Make sure customer support in any form of live chat, call, email is readily and easily available. Some of the scenarios for testing must include landing on a product page from an organic search, finding a product from the home page, ordering the product, editing items in the cart, the volume of items, removing orders, etc. Contacting customer support, tracking the order. Usability testing is a non-negotiable today. Usability testing helps you understand how real people use your product at every step of the development process. Ultimately, when a product works better, it makes it easier to market to, sell to, and onboard users. For optimal results, tailor the process to your product and your target market, and avoid common mistakes like starting too late or not selecting a varied testing group that covers your bases. Friends, hope you have gained some useful insights from this usability testing tutorial. Again, please like, share, subscribe, and comment, so that we remain motivated to come up with such knowledge-sharing videos. Thanks for watching all our videos. See you in the next one.